What's up, guys? Leopold the Brave here. I'm doing an audition for Planet Dolan. I know this is a very odd thing and it seems weird for my channel, but I'm doing it anyways. I have no clue if they're looking for any more positions right now, but I enjoy their content, so I figured, why not? Basically, what I'll be doing is narrating one of their articles from their website. I know they've already made a video on this, but this is just sort of a tryout to see if I can chip in if they ever need any extra help. But with that said, from sponging off people's Wi-Fi to blocking ads on websites, we look at 9 things you do that are actually illegal. Number 9, sampling at the supermarket. Have you ever plucked a couple grapes from a bag in the produce section and popped them in your mouth? If so, then it could be considered theft. Customers may say they have to sample the grapes to test them. And while it might be a good argument, just think about it. They don't do the same when they buy meat from the case, milk from the cooler, or bread from the bakery. Imagine seeing a customer open a bag of bread and sample a slice to make sure it's not stale. A representative from the National Association for Shoplifting Prevention says that doing such a thing in a supermarket is considered stealing. Number 8. Using someone else's Wi-Fi. Turning on your laptop or tablet and selecting one of the available Wi-Fi signals may be convenient if you really need the use of the internet, but it's also illegal. In the United States, there are federal and state laws that say people can't connect to another Wi-Fi network unless they have authorization, although these rules can vary. Even though using someone else's Wi-Fi is very common, this law is barely enforced, possibly because it's hard to detect illegal use. Despite enforcement of this law, people have still been arrested. One guy in Florida was arrested and charged with unauthorized access to a computer network, which is a third-degree felony. So it's probably better just to get your own. It's not a piggyback ride worth taking. Number 7. Not picking up poop. Nobody likes to pick up poop left by their beloved dogs, but not doing so in public can cost owners a lot of money. Many states have laws where you must pick up after your dogs or pay hefty fines. The state of New Jersey even says that dog owners must pick up after their dogs on a weekly basis, even in their own properties. The United States isn't the only country with laws that require owners to pick up after their dogs either. Canada and the United Kingdom are two others. Chances are that such laws exist because, contrary to popular belief, dog poop is actually harmful to the environment and cannot be used as manure. This is because a dog's diet is much different than that of a cow's. This is something to remember when taking your dog for a walk. Number 6. Using a fake name. This is something many internet users have done to try and protect their identity, or maybe to use as a joke. However, entering fake information to gain access anywhere on the internet is illegal. Just ask the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act. Entering false information into a website to gain access in a way its owner didn't authorize is considered hacking, and could get you arrested. The penalty is 5 to 20 years in prison. One man in Rhode Island created a fake Facebook account of his boss, which landed him in hot water. He had to pay $500 to the victim's indemnity fund, all for using fraudulent information. Number 5. Blocking ads. Most internet users hate viewing websites only to have all those pesky ads in the way. Ad blocking software can get rid of the ads, creating many benefits for the user, such as faster loading speed, but it's illegal. While impossible to enforce, ad blockers make it so a user can view a website for free. Most of these websites depend on these ads to keep them going. As a result of ad blocking software, advertisers can lose up to billions of dollars in revenue. Come on, guys, you can wait at least 5 seconds for the skip this ad button to show up. Number 4. Creating memes. Creating memes from copyrighted images, that is. Unless the picture or video is in the public domain, it's illegal to create memes without permission from the image's owner. Something to remember is fair use. A copyrighted image can be turned into a meme without the permission of the original owner for the purposes of commentary, teaching, criticism, or reporting, according to the Supreme Court. However, memes are so common that it's unlikely you'll get in trouble. Number 3. Not declaring eBay earnings. Many eBay users don't declare the money they've earned from selling their items. This is probably because they don't think it's taxable income, but it is, and not declaring it can be considered tax evasion. When eBay users sell items, it's considered to be an online store, hence a business transaction. So if you sell items on eBay and turn out a profit, be sure to let the IRS know. Number 2. Swearing in public. Almost everyone does it, which means that almost everyone has broken the law. It turns out that swearing in public is illegal in certain places. If you swear, you're considered to be disturbing the peace, which is a crime. There have been many instances where people have gotten in trouble for putting their dirty mouth in public display. A Michigan man was arrested and convicted for violating an old anti-profanity law after getting upset when his canoe capsized in a river. Another incident happened to rapper 50 Cent, who was arrested and fined for swearing during one of his concerts in the Caribbean. Anti-profanity laws are barely enforced, but it's best to use caution when in public. Aw, come on guys, what are you doing? What happened to my freedom of speech? What else am I supposed to say when I drop my ice cream cone? Number 1. Possessing a Sharpie. While it may sound like a joke, possessing a permanent marker in public is illegal thanks to the anti-graffiti laws. Other than spray paint, which can also be illegal to possess in public depending on where you are, permanent markers can also be used for vandalism. Although it's not clear if this goes for every state, it's a law in at least 4: New York, Oklahoma, Florida, and California. A middle school student was arrested for possessing a Sharpie in Oklahoma City. His math teacher made a citizen's arrest, and when the police came, they brought him into a holding facility. Alright, that's it. Thanks for watching.
Have a good one!